Hi everyone, it's Jenny with the How and Why of Mathematics, and today I'm going to be going over some of the hardest questions from the senior division of the Australian Mathematics Competition. And these are students around 17 years old, so if you're looking for something a bit easier, then check out my previous video on the junior division questions. So I'll start you off with something not too hard. 5% of students got this one right, so it's not too bad. And the question is to find the area of the region defined by this inequality, absolute value of x plus absolute value of y plus absolute value of x plus y less than or equal to 2. So you might like to pause the video here, have a go at that, and then come back and see my solution. So we need to graph this inequality. And the idea with absolute values is that you want to just consider one region where you know whether x and y are positive or not, and x plus y, if that's negative or positive, because then you can rewrite the equation without the absolute values. So for example, we could concentrate on the section where both x and y are positive, so up here, and then x plus y is going to be positive as well. Then in this region, the absolute value of x is just going to be equal to x. And that's just going to be equal to y, and that's just going to be equal to x plus y. So the equation becomes that in this region. And then we can simplify that. So that's 2x plus 2y, and then let's divide both sides of the equation by 2, both sides of the inequality, rather. That gives us x plus y less than or equal to 1. So that's a straight line. Like, you can rearrange this, if you like, to be y less than or equal to negative x plus 1. And then it's a line with a y-intercept of 1 and a slope of negative 1. So that's going to be like that. Well, that's 1 and that's 1. All right, that's that bit. Now, if we go down here, then y is going to be negative and x is going to be positive. But x plus y could be negative or positive, depending. So what we're going to have to do is consider like two different cases, x plus y is greater than 0 or x plus y is less than or equal to 0. And that's going to split along that line. Because, for example, if x plus y is greater than 0, that means y is greater than negative x. So if you graphed y equals negative x, that would be this line. So this region is going to be different from that region. In this region, you've got x is positive, so absolute value of x is just x. Absolute value of y is negative y, because y is negative there. And then if x plus y is positive in this region, then that absolute value of x plus y is just x plus y. So then we just need to simplify this. The y's will cancel, and then we've got 2x, so let's divide both sides of the inequality by 2. We get x less than or equal to 1. So that is, the x equals 1 is that line there, and we just want to keep it within this region. We don't want to like extend it that way or that way, because this is only valid in this little triangle thing here. Alright, now we can move on to this section. So again, we've got x minus y, but x plus y is negative inside here, so we have to do negative x plus y. And then we'll simplify that. The x's will cancel. We get negative 2y. So let's divide both sides by negative 2, and that's going to flip the inequality. So it started off as less than or equal to, it's going to be greater than or equal to when you divide or multiply by a negative number. So we've got y greater than or equal to negative 1. Now the line y equals negative 1 is along there, and again we don't want to extend it outside of this region. Okay, and then over here, x and y are both negative, and so is x plus y. So that makes things easier. We've got negative x minus y minus the x plus y. That's less than or equal to 2. And let's simplify this. So we've got negative 2x minus 2y. And then let's divide both sides by the negative 2. So again, that's going to flip the inequality. And then if you like, you can rearrange this so it's negative x minus 1. So that's a line with a slope of negative 1 and a y-intercept of negative 1. So y-intercept of negative 1, and it's going like that. Oh, that point is at negative 1, and that's at negative 1 as well. Now we could continue with these regions, but what I'm going to do instead is just thinking about this equation. It's actually symmetric with respect to swapping x and y. What I mean by that is that when you switch x and y in this equation, so like if I go like this, so just swapping x and y, it's actually the exact same equation because the order doesn't matter when we add things. Now what that means for the graph is that when you swap x and y in the graph, it should be the same picture, basically. Now swapping x and y in the graph is the same as reflecting along that line. So this bit, I can just flip that over here, and it should be exactly the same. You can just go through the same process for these two regions as well, writing out the equation. But this is a good shortcut. Okay, so this is the region that we want. All of this in here. We're just going to work out that area. Now, you could do, like, you could split it into these two squares and the two triangles and do like half Bayesian height, or you could imagine cutting this bit off and sticking it down there to make a full square. So we get three full squares. So the area is going to be 3. That's the answer. All right, that's it for this video. So let me know in the comments if you're still confused about anything about this question. And if you want to see more videos like this, then be sure to give me a thumbs up and subscribe and click the bell so you can get notified when I post new videos. And stay tuned for the next one.